chosen a film in Swedish by Thomas Tranströmer. As some of you might recall, he won the Nobel Prize for Literature some years ago. He's a Swedish poet now at age, I think he's about 80, and he writes very contemplative poetry. And I will read the first one, which is called Preludium, like prelude. And you can see the translation over there, but I don't think you... Are you able to read it?
Yes.
More or less? Okay. Mm-hmm. So I will read it in Swedish. Uppvaknandet är ett fallskärmhopp från drömmen. Fri från den kvävande virveln sjunker resenären mot morgonens gröna zon. Tingen flammar upp. Han förnimmer i dallrande lärkans position de mäktiga trätrodens systemen under jorgiskt svängande lämpor. Men ovan jord står i tropisk flöde grönskan med lyftade armar lyssnande till rytmen från ett osynligt pumpverk. Och han sjunker mot sommaren, firas ned i dess bländande krater, ned genom schakt av grönfuktiga åldrar, skälvande under solturbinen. Så hejdas den lodrätta färd genom ögonblicket och vingarna breddas till fiskljusens villa över ett strömmande vatten. Bronsåldersluren fredlösa ton hänger över det bottenlösa. I dagens första timmar kan medvetandet omfatta världen som handen griper en solvarm sten. Resenären står under trädet. Skall efter störtningen genom dödens virvel, ett stort ljus vecklas ut över hans huvud. The idea that when you wake up, it's like a leap from the air, from the sky. I found it such an astounding image. I thought this has to be a wonderful poem. And I read further, and he has the magic of combining these very organic images of the under. I have to take out that I don't start speaking in Swedish. That he combines the image of the organic of nature with a very contemplative view on the world, because in the last stanza he also explains or wonders if after you have woken up and after, one can say, even after you died, after you went to sleep and you wake up again, will there be the great light shining on your head or not? So you can read on two levels, very literally, when you wake up, will you see light or not? And after you die and then perhaps you wake up again, will there be light, and also this image, I'm a person who prefers images to mere words, of the hand that takes this stone which has been in the sun and has this warmth. I could really feel the warmth, and that's the reason why I chose this poem.
It's very nice. Okay.
And there's another one, I can only read it in Dutch. Are there people who understand Dutch here? It's one of the famous poems. I have to look it up and I'll find it. Yes, it's one of the famous poems in the Dutch literature by Gerrit Koenaar. He still lives, he's about 90s now. He still writes poetry. Was and is a very hermetic poet, so writes very dense poetry, but still has wonderful imagery too. This poem is about writing poetry and what he tries to aspire, and he compares it to a lot of contrasts and paradoxes that can't be true, but in poetry become true. Ik heb nooit naar iets anders getracht dan dit. Het zacht maken van stenen, het vuur maken uit water, het regen maken uit dorst. Ondertussen beet de kou mij, was de zon een dag vol wespen, was het brood zout of zoet, en de nacht zwart naar behoren, of wit van onwetendheid. Soms verwarde ik mij met mijn schaduw, zoals men het woord met het woord kan verwarren, het karkas met het lichaam. Vaak waren de dag en de nacht eender gekleurd, en zonder tranen, en doof. Maar nooit iets anders dan dit. Het zacht maken van stenen, het vuur maken uit water, het regen maken uit dorst. Het regent, ik drink, ik heb dorst. Dank u.